which makes for, you know, confusion and inconsistency. So both of those can be dealt with. Life will be a lot easier for applicants, mm-hmm. and easier to, for everybody to administer.
So would you want to have a meeting on that issue sometime?
Yes.
You know, you can come up with what you'd like to see, and then invite the other chairman or members or whatever you want to do it.
Yeah.
Just anybody talking.
Actually, invite both commissions.
And Mark and Heritage to.
To one of these meetings.
Right.
In the near future, and you know, this group can meet with them, and we can lay it out for them. And
it involves the planning board too, though.
Yes.
The ZBA element.
Well, we got one in here. You can help us with that.
Yeah. What about the county?
The county?
Yeah, when the county has to review.
That's a whole separate.
Okay. Law. Yeah, that's. Not much you can do about
that. Yeah, we can't combine that, unfortunately.
Should we perhaps come up with a plan and then get the heads of the other groups
yes.
involved?
I think that this group should drive yeah. what the proposed plan yeah. is, or the consolidation, or whatever it is, and then, and then present
right.
it, I think.
Well, I mean, we've had these discussions
yeah.
before, Hayes.
We just send it out ahead of time so they can at it and we'll come and talk about it.
Mm-hmm. Right, it's part of it trying to align their meetings when you get down to the five. So you're not
that
waiting.
Could be part of the plan. Have it all on one night or something like that or something.
Well, in the past it was always, you know, that you had a client sitting at the table waiting for review and they meet it next month. Or something like that, you know. In other words, you know,
they just missed the
make it flow. Yeah, you just missed submitting it, you know.
Or
right.
maybe dual approvals or something. We have talked right. about just simultaneous meetings.
Yeah.
The objective really would be to eliminate those dual approvals,
right.
but you know, on the same, if you're dealing with the same subject matter, by and large, there'll be one agency that you deal with,
mm-hmm.
not two or three.
Yeah.
Okay.
We can write Sue and I can put together a brief memorandum, maybe not even worry too much about the legalese and the language, but just putting forth
right.
what the proposal is in this space.
Well, maybe Hayes, as chair of Heritage, you might want to sit in on that.
Sure.
And I'll get someone from the Landmarks Preservation Commission. Maybe we can work on that. Jim can come. I mean, you know, we can, in a small subgroup of us,
sure.
then put something together to present to the full committee.
Yeah,
okay, that sounds good. And I think we should have another meeting just for the planning one and the zoning one. And then we can maybe research the proposed use requirement and see if that's necessary to do that or we should do that or you know what I mean?
Yeah.
We'll talk to our legal counsel and see what they advise us and things like that.
Sounds good.
Sounds like a plan.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so next meeting?
So make a meeting for Dan and then we'll talk about it. We'll send one out.
We'll try and meet in that smaller subgroup within the next couple of weeks.
Okay. Yeah, definitely.
Does that work?
Sooner than later. It's not around like St. Patrick's Day.
Week before and the week after.
No. It's got to be 2 weeks before and 2 weeks after.
While the camera's rolling there, I just like to compliment Dan and your counterparts, maybe partners, you know, looking through this before this meeting, just amazing that we have discussed this much and putting this down on paper, so it's
Yeah, it's a little vague when we're doing it every month.
Thank you very much, appreciate it.
Because at times I had my doubts whether it was going to come together, obviously.
So thank you, I appreciate that. And, you know, working on something like this, what if C end up accomplishing it, not, you know, going through and moving a lot of paper around and having a lot of yak and then nothing ever happens? That's not very satisfying for anybody.
This is a question, document is going to be a legal document, obviously. It's going to be brand new in sections. What is the plan in terms of somebody maybe with a legal eye or a proofreading eye or whatever? I mean, you don't want to find out you have a typo in the middle of a hearing of some sort and the lawyer putting the full weight on that in the courtroom.
Well, when we got a package that we're ready to proceed with, we refer it to the Corporation Counsel's office for legal review.
Yes, it's going to be a new legal document.
Yep.
All right, so we need to set a date now or no?
I will probably send around a poll and ask. I'll throw out the dates and times. It's 6 o'clock at night.
6:30 is better.
6:30 is better.
Fine by me. It's kind of tough getting here at 6, to be honest with you.
Okay. I'll throw out some dates.
Which meeting are you talking about? With me? The one do you want to have?
Well, I included you in the list. It's with the Heritage, Landmarks, you, me, Noble.
You're talking about that. So, okay.
Yeah.
So we ought to have a meeting for this committee afterwards, so we should pick a night tonight or at the same time, so we got a target afterwards.
Okay. I'll do it. That'll be a separate, though.
Okay.
Anybody have any questions? Any minutes? Back?
Okay. Are you going to take questions from the residents, or is it open to?
Well, you could probably ask a question, but we're still like trying to formulate. We don't have a specific plan yet. What are we gonna?
A few things. The what is being made public? I didn't see the agenda online, or I saw minutes for 2 past meetings. Have you had only 2 meetings so far? Only 2 meetings, minutes.
We didn't have a meeting last month, but then.
But only 2 total are online, and only the agenda for one of them is online, and not this one.
Yeah. So this came in late this afternoon. So.
Okay. The progress report, is that going to be accessible?
I can post that.
Right.
Is this draft online?
This draft, no. I didn't put it online yet.
I see things here, the urban core design standards, is that like the Rondeau East Side, or has that become a real topic, urban design core standards? Is there talk of mixed use or extending mixed use sections or anything sort of revolutionary like that? Or is it just sort of, is it mainly just finding the status?
The urban core design standards are an effort to get things more organized. Presently, there are 3 different design districts in the city. Each one has a different set of standards, even though they're very similar. They're different. This is putting the 3 of them together.
Integrating
making one set of standards which would apply to all 3 areas, and in instances where there is a special consideration, such as uptown, the stockade, there would be a small section which incorporates these special standards that apply just to the stockade area. But basically, it would be a set of design standards which apply to all of the design districts, rather than 3 different standards.
Have there been, has there been any talk about things like, I don't know if this would fall under this category, but I know that parking regulations affect the way that Kingston runs very much so. We're not allowed to have small neighborhood walkable stores. They can be grandfathered in if they stay in business, but then after a year they go out of business, you're not allowed to have them without a special variance. Has there been any talk about those old ways of traditional neighborhood staples, ways of allowing those back in, going around parking regulations, getting away from car-centric design?
No, it hasn't been, you know, it's not part of the scope of work, which is not to say that they're not items that are worthy of discussion. It's just, this was the basic scope of our sort of work came out of recommendations in the comprehensive plan. There are other things which are probably appropriate and should be addressed, but those two are not on the list at the moment.
But the Midtown Urban Core, your presentation in the draft here, the Midtown Urban Core lends itself, you know, with the form-based design, mm-hmm. lends itself to what some of the you're saying in terms of the streetscape and the design of the buildings, and I mean, that was the impression I got.
Yeah,
that's what you mean.
For instance, I think, like, wouldn't it be lovely to be able? It would be nice to not have such a long road if it could branch out a bit more. I know that we're going to get the bowling alley made into a mixed use thing. It would be great to have that easier. It happened more easily to be part of something where people wouldn't always have to get variances, maybe an extension of business districts leading into other districts, and then allowing for original use, possibly affordable stores.
One of the different things that came out of the plan was with the Midtown overlay district, which sets standards for what's called form-based development. Basically, it's not so much interested in the use. You allow a variety of uses that can function together, whether it be residential or commercial. And in a building or a building framework where you emphasize sidewalks and access on the street, storefronts. And it's particularly interesting in the Midtown area. If you look,
since I got a look at the map, I don't know if you can see it or not, but this red outline there is this Midtown overlay district. And it includes Broadway from about the hospital past UPAC. And it does go, it goes down Cornell Street. It includes the Bowling Alley project. And attempt to make a really a concentrated, mixed-use, urban development district. And it establishes a procedure for review and approval where somebody who's really complying with all of the objectives and standards can get a fairly quick approval process.
It would require a variance. It wouldn't just be new use allowed.
No variance. So it's an overlay district. If someone comes in and can satisfy the standards, it's a permitted use. And they have to go through site plan approval and things, but it's and particularly in this area, which is now, this red area is sliced up sort of randomly in six different zoning districts, ranging from manufacturing to residential. And I'm always struck by, you take a look, the objectives for both uptown and downtown are essentially to preserve that. It's already got the character of fairly concentrated urban development on a streetscape buildings fronting on the street. You want to preserve it and protect it. Midtown is different. It has some of that, but not a great deal. You take a look, it always strikes me looking at this photograph, this is a huge amount of open paved parking in this area, which is...
Yeah. It was the last comprehensive plan that made this happen, to that sort of these parking requirements and divisions of uses, and destroyed that sort of cross-use, mixed-use walkability.
At the moment, it provides an opportunity to rebuild to a different set of standards, which I think are more in tune with where the city is these days, where municipal concentrated city development is at. But anyway, that district is probably going to be a major new departure.
Okay, so there is a mixed-use overlay in this plan.
Yes.
That's heartening. And what about Rondo? I know that the east side is there's a talk of making it more like the better side.
West side.
And the west side, the good side.
Well, the proposal is Rondout is also interesting in a different way, in that there are, you know, there are districts in the Rondout which don't exist anyplace else in the city, both on the west side and the east side. They're two distinct districts. There's no comparable one anyplace else in the city. For whatever reason, however, particularly they treat one side of Broadway different than the other in terms of which uses are permitted under what circumstances. So we're proposing removing that so that both sides of Broadway have similar uses permitted under similar ground rules. The other change in the Rondout would be that although there's those three design districts I mentioned is called the Rondout District, it really only applies to that narrow strip between Beale Street and the Strand. Not to forget, between the Strand and the creek, other than the fact it's a historic district, but there are none of the design standards apply to the west side of Broadway from the Strand, all the way up to at least Spring Street. These new standards, or combined standards that I mentioned before, would now be made to apply to that stretch of Broadway as well.
The design standards that you referred to, are these something that is a known standard, that somebody can research and understand?
I'm talking about design standards that are presently in the city zoning plan.
Okay.
We've proposed making them minor revisions in terms of making them not quite as detailed and specific, and also using them as a way to present what the objectives of the standards are, rather than just putting down the actual cold standards, and making them uniform for all three areas that they apply to.
Okay. Thank you. Lastly, Ravine. Has there ever really talked about Ravine? It used to be a very commercial, I think I've got the name up in the street right, you walk along the water and you end up at Ravine, and it used to be a commercial corridor. It has all storefronts, but now it's only residential. And this would be thinking in the future, new owners might want to have stores there. Wouldn't that be a great location for taking back what was lost in the last comprehensive plan? Allowing for mixed use there where it historically was and still has the infrastructure to be, and the location. And the whole block going up.
Up Ravine.
Yeah. It's all storefronts.
Ravine, well, talking Ravine or what? You're talking Ward Street?
One block.
Up to German Street.
Yeah, but they've all turned into homes or offices or something. Mm. But wouldn't that be a great, vibrant place and also sort of a good connection of the water to it?
Well, it's the first time the subject has come up.
You said you said Ravine Street versus, as opposed to Worst?
No, she's talking about Ravine, up to above German, there are commercial storefronts.
There's more.
At the light of Ravine and Abbeville, if you go up on the right, there are storefronts, there used to be commercial, and then it turns, starts turning into.
Because you have a similar, an area on Worst Street, up at the top, Spring Street where the firehouse is and whatnot, where there was a couple of blocks.
And it's illegal to have a shop there now.
No, the Rondell zoning allows commercial use of those buildings which were originally designed for commercial use.
They can go back without getting, without having to prove parking.
Yeah.
Right now.
Well.
I don't think they can, no. They have to prove parking, you have to basically build a parking lot. Which is a shame.
Anybody else have any questions?
Yeah, I don't see anything about the zoning for natural areas, and I'm, you know, the Conservation Advisory Council sent comments in.
There is a large section in there on.
On the hillside.
Natural protection of natural resources, a wetlands loss of.
Yeah, but it was just, it was, you know, forgive me for being blunt, but it was just taken from somewhere else, it wasn't necessary. Are there gonna be changes to that? We commented on that. When are we gonna hear back?
You commented when?
Or did you want some, be asked to be on the agenda? So when are, you know, and there was just tiny parts of some of, you know, so I just was wondering, we sent our documents in, it took us a while to get copies, it took us a while to comment, they were sent in about 2 weeks ago, and I didn't see them on the list here, I don't.
Sue, you got it?
I will look, I thought it was.
Would you send it to?
Sue, and, Sue and, Jim Noble. And I think that in the comprehensive plan, beginning bringing up her, I think there were some kind of guiding principles that talked about walkable, being able to go and walk to whatever you needed to get, which is the corner store concept. Don't quote me on that, but I thought that that was in there. But so is there, what's the next step on the natural areas?
Well, if you've got comments, we'll certainly take a look at it.
Well, we'd be happy to come and explain our comments, and you know, some of them were just referring to other ideas from other places. But certainly for the wetlands and water course law, that's a really important section, and it needs to be refined for the city. And we felt like there was more information that covered on some of the other topics within that.
We'll probably try and let you know when we're gonna look at that, right? Instead of coming, because we don't even know if we'll get it at the next meeting or whatever. So when we get to that particular area, we'll have you come in and you can fill us in on it. Anybody else want to say anything before we adjourn? No?
So it's my understanding that the minutes of all meetings have to be up on the website within like 24 or 72 hours or something. So can we expect to see that? I know that's what our commissions are held to.
The city doesn't have anything like that.
It came from the mayor.
Well, the mayor should have something here to do it with then. Maybe propose, but we certainly don't have that into effect right now. So there's no city committee that takes minutes other than council.
Okay, well, I'll check on that, but I know we're rushing to get ours out. And then we,
what do you give
as
them?
A draft, we They go on the website.
Well, how do they get there, though? Somebody take them and record them or something?
Well, someone's typing really hard during the meeting.
Then you mail to him, and then he puts them on?
And I assume that they go on whoever the webmaster is.
Do you do that at planning or anything?
I do planning board, yeah. We put the, we post the...
The minutes on you?
Audio tape up the next day.
Yeah, well, that makes sense.
No, we're not taping, we're just typing.
Which commission is that?
The Conservation Advisory Council and the Climate Smart Community Use Council.
I mean, you have someone come at the public safety meeting to give us a report from CAC, but I don't think that goes on the website.
All right, well, who should I...
But I don't know if anyone's doing it for us, unless somebody's doing it and didn't let us know, I don't know. I'll find that out. Finance laws and rules, I don't know.
Those are not council. I mean, I'm talking about committees of the common council, I'm talking about appointed commissions.
Oh, okay.
I think, I believe.
Well, I think ours should be on there. Just appointing commissions, but... But we're working on it. We're working on it. Are you involved in that agenda website thing for meetings and...
Yeah.
Oh, you're involved in that. See, that's something new that we're doing.
Yeah, I can do it.
Okay, anyone else?
I have a question. I'm just wondering what the process is in terms of the public. Like, is there a point where there's public hearings on this, or do we have the... It sounds like it's...
So will we have hearings?
So we'll be able to...
Public hearings, and then it goes to the committees, you know, like laws and rules, and you could come speak there, whatever.
So I think it's more to clarify that there's going to be a public hearing process for what this working group proposes.
Comes up with, right.
And then, once it's presented to the common council, there'll be a public hearing when it gets to that stage, right?
Public hearing is conducted by the laws and rules committee, and then goes to the public council.
Public hearing by the laws and rules committee of the common council. They would have another public hearing.
So you have plenty of time.
This is not a decision-making body.
Right.
This is going to be the body that's trying to come up with a recommendation that will then have public, will be heard publicly.
I was under the impression that this was, the draft was being presented tonight, so I guess I was just confused, like, at what point does that happen in the public?
Working document, yeah.
So this, but earlier we were talking about sort of the July, August timeframe to have something ready to present to the common council.
And then it would be presented to the common council, and the public could also...
Absolutely.
Yeah, I envision us having a more public hearing on it before we finally vote as a group to recommend it to the common council. Then the common council rules committee would have a public hearing on it also.
Okay, got it, thank you.
Okay, all set? Nobody else? Good? By staying adjourned. The next meeting, which should be notified.